The students, now let me discuss some examples on freeway diagram. Now we have to draw the freeway diagram of this system. Here the mass M1, M2 and M3 are placed on one after another. Now let me discuss about the freeway diagram of this object, of this system. Here, for the mass M1, due to its weight, a force M1g will be acting downwards. So the ground will also given a normal direction N1, which is given here. So one is M1g, which is acting downwards, and N1, which is acting upwards. And another force N2 here is acting due to the mass M2. Because this mass M2, due to its weight, give a normal reaction on M1 in downward direction. So here is another force, that is N2, which is acting on the mass M1. So for mass M1, three forces are acting. One is due to its weight, M1g. Another is the normal reaction given by the ground, that is N1. And another is the normal reaction given by the M2 on M1 in downward direction. So according to Newton's third law, this N2 force also acts in upward direction on N2. So this N2 force will also arises on M2 on upward direction. When we draw the freeway diagram of M2, this N2 will be act on M2. And due to its weights, M2g will be acting downwards. And another force N3 will appear here due to the contact surface between M3 and M1. Because the M3 will exert a reaction force in downwards direction. That is N3. So here N3 will also acting downwards. And when M3 will act a force N3 on the mass M2, then according to Newton's third law, this M3 will also exert by the same force on M2, that is N3. So when you draw the freeway diagram of M3, this N3 force will acting upwards on the body M3, and there is another force due to its weights, that is M3g. So these are the freeway diagram of mass M1, M2 and M3 for this system. Now let us take another example, which is shown in figure over here. Here there is two contact surface. One is this surface and another is this surface. So on these surfaces there will must act a normal reaction on the body. As you know, the normal reaction is always perpendicular to the surface. So here the normal reactions due to this surface will be acting in this direction, and due to this surface will acting in this direction. So if you consider this as N1 and this as N2, then these two will be acting on this body like this. And these two normal reactions will must pass through the center of this object, because any radius of a circle or of a sphere is normal to its surface. So here N1 and N2 will must pass through the center of this object. I have also discussed earlier that for symmetric body, the normal reaction always passed through the center of mass. And another force, that is Mg, will act always downwards. So if we talk about the freeway diagram of this mass M2, will be like this. One is Mg, which is acting downwards. Another is N1, which is acting in this direction. And another is N2, which will acting in this direction. So this will be the freeway diagram of mass M. Now let us take another example over here. Here for the mass M, there is present two string. If you consider that the tensional force in this string is T1 and this string is T2, if this is T1 and this is T2, then these two forces for the mass M will be away from the body, because we all know the tensional force is always away from the body. So for this mass small m, the tensile force will be in this direction, and for this string, that will be in this direction. And there is also another force due to its mass, that is mg. So the three-way diagram of this body will be like this. One force mg in downward direction, another force t1 in leftward direction, and another one is t2, which is making angle theta with the horizontal, like this. So this is the three-way diagram of mass m. Now let's take another example over here. So the two masses m1 and m2 are connected by a string, and a force is acting at an angle theta from the horizontal. So if you talk about the mass m1, then simply there is two forces. One is the normal direction n1, and another is its weight m1g. And another force, this is the tension on the string, which is acting away from the body in this direction. So if we talk about the three-way diagram of mass m1, then it will simply like this: n1, m1g, and t. But if we talk about the three-way diagram of mass m2, then the tensional force for the mass m2 will be acting in this direction, and there is another two forces. One is the normal direction n2, and another is the weight of the body, that is m2g. So the three-way diagram of mass m2 will be like this. One is n2, another is m2g, and the force F, which is acting at an angle theta with the horizon. So this will be the three-way diagram of mass m2. Now let us take another example over here. This is the mass pulley system, and is a very common problem for your board exam as well as for your competitive exam. Now here we have considered the rope or the string is massless, and the pulley is frictionless. So throughout the string, the tensional force will be same. Now the fact is that what is the direction of the tensional force for m1, and what is the direction of the tensional force for m2? As we have discussed earlier, that the tensional force is away from the body. So for the mass m1, this will be acting in this direction, and here is the weight m1g in downward direction. For this body, m2g is downward direction, and the tensional force t is in upward direction. So if you talk about the mass m1, then the three-way diagram will be t outwards and m1g downwards. Similarly, for the mass m2, this will be m2g downwards and t upwards. So these are the some problems based on three-way diagram which we have discussed here. Now these three-way diagrams, we have to draw more and more again and again for the purpose of problem solving techniques. So thank you.